guys, for today's video, I wanted to talk to you about chemical versus physical exfoliants, the two main types of exfoliants found in most skincare routines, and talk about what the differences are, what they mean for your skin, and when they are a good or a bad idea to use. So to first start off, what exactly is an exfoliant? An exfoliant is usually a product or a chemical that is meant to break down different layers of the skin. The skin naturally reproduces and regenerates itself and kind of lets go of old little dead skin cells so that they don't clog up. Now, unfortunately, sometimes things do clog up and those skin cells don't naturally kind of get let go the way they should. This can cause a dull look to the skin. It can cause increased dryness, which leads to increased wrinkling. And of course, it can also cause acne because any blockage on the top of that skin, including dead skin cells, can lead to a big inflamed pore that harbors bacteria and oil. So that being said, that's where exfoliants come in, and these are products or techniques that are used manually that break down those outer layers. Some are done physically and some are done chemically, and for today's video, that's what we're going to talk about. So first, let's talk about chemical exfoliants. You know that we've had so many conversations on this channel about AHA and BHA acids, two categories of acids that are meant to actually break down the skin, either breaking down those outer cells themselves or breaking down the oil and the dirt and the glue that holds them to your face so that they can be let go naturally. A chemical exfoliant is normally made with AHA or BHA acids, but it can have other ingredients and other active ingredients as well. But the main thing about a chemical exfoliant is that usually they are really soft to the touch. Whereas some exfoliants you may be familiar with have kind of grains or seeds to them, most chemical exfoliants are actually extraordinarily smooth, and they use microparticles to break down those layers of the skin. Now, because of that, this usually happens very evenly. So that means wherever the product is applied, there is even exfoliation going on all throughout the skin. This one happens to be from Juice Beauty. It's the green apple peel, which has malic acid. And if you want to know about the AHA and BHA acids, I will link you to videos in the bottom tab that kind of describe those a little bit more in depth. But this is a natural organic product, and it is a chemical exfoliant. Now, who should be using a chemical exfoliant? Because they exfoliate so evenly, they are really great for people who have aging problems, for people who have acne, or for people who have sensitive skin. Sometimes more abrasive or kind of textured products, which is what we'll talk about next, can irritate the skin if they're not being used properly. So if you've got aging problems, if you really need things to penetrate deep, chemical exfoliants are the way to go. The next category of exfoliants are physical exfoliants. And these are how they sound. They are a physical way of breaking down those top layers of the skin. Now, there are tools which are physical exfoliants, such as the Clarisonic, which I don't personally use anymore, but those are another way of manual physical exfoliation. But there are also products that are meant to exfoliate physically. So this is one example, which is a natural product from Zoo Beauty, which has apricot kernel and quinoa in it. And this product actually has little beads in it, little microparticles that kind of buff away at the skin. And this is probably the one that you're most familiar with. Now, these are great because they go onto the skin manually and remove those outer layers with a rubbing motion. Now, this is especially great if you have rosacea. This is especially great if you do have younger skin. And there are a lot of people who like to actually feel their skincare. And these are products in which you will be able to do that. One thing that I would caution you is that sometimes if you're doing this manually, it doesn't always exfoliate evenly the way a chemical exfoliant would. So that being said, you really want to make sure that you're rubbing the exact same circular motion and the exact same amount of time on all of the areas of your face. Now, that also being said, chemical exfoliants normally go a bit deeper than physical exfoliants. So if you do have skin that you don't want products to really penetrate and irritate, if you really just need some surface exfoliation, or if you have like dry winter skin and you just need a patch to come off, physical exfoliants are the way to go. Now, because I have suffered with acne and because I've spoken so much about acne on this channel, I do just want to say that there are certain physical exfoliants that can aggravate acne. For instance, St. Ives apricot scrub or Burt's Bees walnut scrub. Those have very jagged pieces of an actual kernel in it. The stone of a fruit inside of them. And unfortunately, if those scratch at the skin unevenly, they can cause micro tears. Now, sometimes micro tears are good. I recently got a peel that actually micro teared my skin on purpose to let beneficial ingredients in and promote collagen so I could get rid of some acne scarring. But if you're not actually working in a sanitized and sterile environment using products and ingredients that are beneficial to the skin, unfortunately, sometimes that at-home exfoliation with a manual product product that cuts the skin can cause micro tears that end up allowing bad bacteria into the skin and causing problems. So if you do have acne, I would say use and choose your physical exfoliants carefully. But if you've got young skin, if you've got dry patches, physical exfoliants are the way to go. So that being said, what do I recommend for personal exfoliants? The Juice Beauty one is one of my favorites. Anything with glycolic acid has always been good for me. And again, I'll link you to that video on acids. When it comes to physical exfoliants, I do love this one from Zoo Beauty. They are a B Corporation, which means that they are a social good company that supports local farmers. And this product uses quinoa in their skincare. And this is a manual scrub that contains that, which I really like. Two others that I want to give an honorable mention to are a little bit different because instead of being called exfoliators, this is actually a moisturizer that has exfoliating properties. And this one is actually a face mask that has exfoliating properties. So this first one is from SkinFX. It's meant for KP, which are those little bumps that some people get on their arms. And it's also good at breaking down keratin, which could, your skin is made of dead keratin, so is your hair and your nails. And sometimes a buildup of that can cause skin issues and texture issues. So this really helps to break that down. So this is a moisturizer. It's got a lot of really good beneficial oils such as jojoba, such as aloe vera, such as almond seed oil, which really moisturize the skin. But it's also got sugarcane extract, which is an AHA acid, which means that although this will moisturize the skin, it also does help to mildly exfoliate on a deeper chemical level to fix some of those problems. The other one I've got here is the green tea face mask from Skin Yoga, and this is specifically an acne face mask. Now what this is an actual powder that you mix with water and you put on your skin as a face mask. And because of the green tea and active ingredients, it's meant to help with acne. Now the reason that this is also an exfoliating product is because when you rub this off, there's actual grains that help to exfoliate the skin. The base of this product is oats. And even though those sit on the skin like a mask, when you actually remove them, you are physically and manually removing a little bit of those outer skin layers. And for me, having acne prone skin, I have been really pleased with this product as a mask that also helps to exfoliate. So that being said, I hope that this video taught you a little bit something about physical versus chemical exfoliants and what the differences are, if you've ever been confused about them or just wanted to learn a little something. If you did find this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you know someone who's struggling with their skincare or trying to learn more about skin or having problems with getting their skincare right, feel free to share this video with them. When you share this video, it helps me spread the message of education and real beauty and helps whoever you shared it with to learn a little bit more about their skin and their products. If you are new here and you haven't subscribed, what are you waiting for? The little ding-dong bell button is like a doorbell and it notifies you whenever I post videos on skincare, on veganism, on healthy living, on fitness, on lifestyle, on my cats, you name it, or when I'm just chilling here in the woods. But that being said, remember that it is you that puts the you in beauty, and to always express that in everything that you think, say, and do. I love you guys so much, and I cannot wait to see you all in the next video. Love you guys. Bye. And yes, I am sitting in a very public park, rubbing very odd-looking products into my skin with absolutely no way to wash them off. Good job, Cassandra. Good job.